Well, howdy, 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 folks. I got a question that got asked, and I wanted to come to you and answer it. And then somebody else had posted something about my hot dog cart keeps getting hot. It's real hot. Hot dog carts, that's why they're called hot dog carts. Otherwise, they'd just be called dog carts because they do get hot. I'm just kidding, but they do get hot. And some carts get way hotter than they should be and way hotter than is safe. But even on the best made carts, they still get hot. It's like a rolling oven. Okay, and on the outside of your oven, it probably gets hot. And to cut down on weight, many manufacturers will go with really thin metal that conducts heat very well. So you end up with a very hot top and a very hot sides and very hot front where you're standing. And there's the potential risk of hurting one of your customers. One of your customers' kids comes up there and touches it. Okay, so I got two things for you. One, get stickers for your cart that say hot, don't touch. You can get little stickers. You can buy them online on eBay. You can buy them on Amazon. Amazon's probably your cheapest bet. And you can buy them from sticker stores. You know, hot, do not touch, or something like that. Caution, hot. Anything like that will work. Put a couple of those on your cart. It helps reduce the liability. Now, what do you do if somebody does touch it? I had a vendor that a little kid touched their cart. The mom sued. Okay, the mom sued. Now, she didn't win, but it's because the vendor had insurance. And it's good to have liability insurance, and I'll help you out with that as well. And I'll give you a link to that. It'll be down in the comments here. And it's the best insurance you can get, period, by far. We've tried many companies. This company is the best, and they provide awesome rates, and they give you a $2 million coverage, and they have their own lawyers. So it's not you against mom who, you know, let her kids run wild at your cart. It's, or dad who let his kids run wild at the cart. It's their lawyers against them, okay? So it's the best way to go, and it protects you, and it's something you should do right from the get-go. Because if somebody got hurt, injured, said, hey, I bit my tongue while I was eating your hot dog, and now I'm suing you, because anybody can sue anybody for anything. Doesn't mean they're gonna win, but it's better to have some lawyers on your side, and it's very well worth the money. I mean, it's just a deal and a half. It's less than a dollar a day, and if you're a VU member, a Vendors United member, it's even cheaper. Cheapest prices for insurance in the world. In the world, okay? Out of all companies, best prices through Vendors United. But bottom line is, I'm going to also put a link for you about the different types of insurance and why you need insurance and how that will cover you and how it will help. Explain it a little more, and I'll have a link for that as well. So that's the two things you need to do. A sticker and then a insurance. Now there's a third bonus item, and there's more. Okay, here's the more. Is you can set up your cart, like set up your table or set up your trash can in places that prevent and kind of steer them away from those hot areas. Most vendors set up in a way so that people logically look at it and go, this is where I need to come to. And then you just have your sticker there on one side of the cart because that's where they would come up to instead of stickering the whole cart. So those are the ideas for you. I hope that helps. And be sure to click the links down below. They'll go to the blog article where I talk about this more and explain it more if you have the need for understanding it better and some of the ins and outs of insurance, plus the link to get the best insurance for the best price for any type of street food vending. Hope that helps. Love you. Talk to you soon.